Good morning, everyone. Welcome to your fluid mechanics experiment number 2. In this experiment, you will measure the pressure distribution around a cylinder in the cross flow. In order to do this experiment, you need the wind tunnel, the water manometer, and of course, the special designed cylinder. We will mount the cylinder in this way, and the airflow will be in this direction. This special designed cylinder has 10 holes on the surface. Each hole will be connected individually to a tube like this. And each tube will be later individually connected to the water manometer. So when we mount the cylinder into the working area of the wind tunnel, hole number 1 will be horizontal. So we'll actually measure the pressure distribution at the 0 degree angle. Hole number 2 will be able to measure the pressure distribution at 20 degree angle. Hole number 3 will be able to measure the pressure distribution at 60 degree angle. Okay? So that's how we measure the pressure distribution over the surface. Now we need to mount the cylinder to the wind tunnel. Remember to align the pin with the support on the other side of the wind tunnel. Okay. Also remember you need to align those two markers to make sure that hole number 1 will be 0 degree, which is horizontal direction. Lock the device. Then we need to connect the cylinder to the water manometer with the quick release 10-way connector. Just make a good contact and lock the device. Now the cylinder is ready to use. We now can power on the wind tunnel, then come to the computer. Click on the icon on the desktop and pick up exercise D and click on load. You will see a pop-up window like this. First thing we need to do is change the temperature value from 18 degrees to 25 degrees. This is the temperature in this lab. And you also noticed the watchdog enabled has been illuminated, which means now the connection between the wind tunnel and the software and the computer has been built. So we will be able to start to use the wind tunnel right now. So we can start the fan. You click on the fan on, the number will be automatically changed from 0 to 1. Now we can increase the fan speed from 0 potential to 20% potential. You will see the fan start running. Wait for about 60 seconds to let the airflow become stable. Then you can start collecting your first set of data. Your first set of data will include the velocity of the airflow, which provided from the software right now is about 6.5 meters per second. Then you need to come to the water manometer to record the data in the water tubes. Be careful that when you read the water level in the water manometer, you have to bend down like this, make sure your sight is perpendicular to the water panel to get accurate read. Okay. So this will be your first set of data. Then you can increase the fan speed to 30%. Again, you have to wait for another 60 seconds to let the airflow become stable. Then you can start collect your second set of data, which includes the air velocity. Right now is about 8.8 meters per second. And also you need to come down over here to the water manometer to read the water levels in the tubes. After this, you can increase the fan speed to 40%. Every time, remember, you have to wait for 60 seconds to let the airflow become stable. Then you can collect the data. So 40% will be your third set of data, which includes the air velocity. Right now is about 11.1 meters per second. And again, you need to come to the water manometer to read the water level in the water manometer carefully. Repeat the same step until you reach 100%. Remember, for 100%, you also need to wait for 60 seconds, then collect your last set of data. Okay? Then gradually slow down the wind tunnel. And this will be your second experiment in fluid mechanics.